Even though black holes hold their title as being the king of the universe, are they immortal? Well, let's get an overview of what a black hole really is. A black hole is a region of space exhibiting gravitational acceleration so strong that nothing the size of an atom can escape it, even light. They are created by collapsing of huge stars 20 times the size of our star. After the implosion, there is a colossal explosion releasing a huge burst of gamma rays that can wipe out life on our planet. What's left is a black hole with mass identical to what was once a star. Any planet still orbiting around the black hole won't be spaghettified. They will orbit the black hole normally like it has been doing for years. This is cool and all, but what does a black hole actually look like? Well, here is a photo of an actual black hole in the center of galaxy Messier 87. Black holes are actually invisible because light can't escape it, so the radio you see is matter being spun at extremely high speeds around the black hole. The friction is causing heat, which then results in X-ray radiation to disperse and eventually be captured by our advanced telescopes. This black hole is 55 million light years away, and like all black holes, has singularity and an event horizon. The singularity is where all the matter in a black hole gets compressed into. They say this is the point of infinite density at the center of a black hole, but this theory may be wrong because this is where classical physics began to break down the science of singularity. The event horizon of a black hole is a zone which light cannot escape once inside this boundary. The reason for this is because the zone's gravity is so high. Once matter is trapped in this zone, it will then be taken into the singularity. Now that we got that out of the way, let's conclude if a black hole is mortal or immortal. Actually, they are mortal. Yep, they die eventually like everything else in the universe. How? Well, like the event horizon we discussed about, things escape from there occasionally, more or less depending on the size of the black hole. For an example, the smaller the black hole, the more radiation given off, the bigger, the less. Size affects radiation because smaller black holes are a lot more active than slow, huge black holes. As this goes on and on, as the black hole is no longer being fed matter, it will spit out all the matter it absorbed in a form of radiation. This is called black hole evaporation, also known as Hawking radiation. So, how do particles escape from black holes anyway? Well, some atomic particles will pop into existence in pairs in empty space, which isn't really empty space because it is filled with subatomic particles. One from the pair is a particle and the other is an antiparticle. They both have the same mass, just different characteristics like their electrical charge. They will annihilate each other when they meet into contact from their opposite charges causing attraction. This process is called annihilation. Once they come together, they will turn into pure energy. When this cycle attempts to happen right on the edge of a black hole, whichever particle is closer in the black hole gets pulled in, and the other particle is free from its suicidal partner and has enough force, or in other words, push, to barely escape the black hole's attraction. This doesn't always happen though. Sometimes both of the particles get pulled back in. If a particle does escape, then the black hole will lose the mass of the particle that escaped. Since the matter escaped and was once part of the black hole's empty space, the black hole has now lost mass. This process continues forever and ever till the black hole loses enough mass to evaporate at an exponentially incredible fast rate till it heats up and explodes to an equivalent of 1 million metric ton hydrogen bombs. This will be how all kings of the galaxy end.